हेलो हाय गाइस, नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू फर्दर। अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज लो बैलेंसिंग केमिकल इक्वेशन। हाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू द अनबैलेंस इक्वेशन, दैट इज अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक। सो दे आर द सम स्टेप्स इन इफ यू विल फॉलो दीज ऑल स्टेप्स, देन अवर इक्वेशन विल बी बैलेंस्ड। सो फॉर फर्दर बैलेंसिंग इक्वेशन यू मस्ट नीड टू हैव अ सम इक्वेशन। इफ सो फॉर अस देर इज अ इक्वेशन, दैट इज हेयर आयरन रिएक्ट विद द वॉटर, इट विल गिव द आयरन ऑक्साइड अलोंग विद द हाइड्रोजन गैस। If the reaction is not into a simple form, just like written at the here, it is in a word form, then first of your duty is to convert it to into a simple form. Just like in that form, that is known as by the chemical equation in a simple forms. So first of all, we will convert the equation into the simple form. Mainly, when the equation is given, it generally present into the equation form. So you don't need to be convert any other thing, you just need to follow the steps. So the first step in the balancing chemical equation, you need to do what? You need to draw the boxes around the each molecules or each compounds or each element present in the equation. Just like in this equation, there are the 1, 2, 3, 4. There is an element iron, there is a compound water, there is a compound iron oxide, and there is an element of the hydrogen gas. Also, there is a molecule of a hydrogen gas. So here we have an element and compounds. So what we should do? We will draw the boxes around each, surrounding the each compounds or each element. So we will draw the box around the iron. We will draw the box around H2O. We will draw the box around Fe3O4. Same way, we will draw box around the hydrogen gas. In this way, we will draw the boxes around each the compounds. So it was the first step. It is the first step in order to balance a chemical equation. Now the second step is just simple. Second step, now you need to do the two thing. You need to find the how many type of element are present in that equation and how many number of these element are present in that equation in the reactant side as well as in the product side. So there are the two steps. There are the two things that we need to solve in the second step. First is to find that how many type of element are present in there. So we will draw the box in such a way, there is a first that the first column of the element, second column of number of atom in the reactant side, number of atom of that element in the product side. So we will continue that type of we will continue this one here. So how many type of element are present in that equation? Here we will see that there are the three type of element are present in that equation. One is iron, next one is hydrogen, and third one is oxygen. So there are the three element present in that equation. Hence we have written at there three type of element. One is iron, second one hydrogen, and third is oxygen. Now in the second column, we will write number of atom of the element present in the reactant side. How many number of these different element present in the reactant side. So first we have taken the iron. So we will look at the iron. Just you have looked at the here, how many atom are present of the iron. There is one atom of iron present on the reactant side, hence we have written the one. How many atom of hydrogen is present? There are two atom of hydrogen present on the reactant side, hence we have written the two. And how many atom of oxygen is present? There is one atom of oxygen is present on the left hand side, so hence we have written the one. So these are the number of the atom of the iron, hydrogen and oxygen present on the reactant side. Now further, we will count the number of these element on the product side. There is a three element of iron present on the product side. So the third column, that is number of atom in the product. So the iron, the number of atom is iron. There is a three number of atom present iron in the product side. So we have write it here three. The next one is oxygen. There are the four atom of oxygen present on the product side. Hence we have written four. Next one is hydrogen. How many number of hydrogen are present? There are the two number of hydrogen present on the product side, hence we have written 2. So 3 atom of iron, 2 atom of hydrogen and 4 atom of oxygen are present on the product side. There's one thing here we need to notice, the number of atoms of the different element present in the reactant side are into the product side. They are not equal number. Hence the equation said to be an unbalanced equation. As we have classified or as we have discussed earlier, the balance equation is one which has an equal number of different element on the reactant and product side. If the number of element in the reactant and product side are not equal, then it will not be considered as a balanced equation. Here it is clearly defined, or it is clearly proved that number of atom in the reactant side of different element and the product side in the different element are not equal. There is a 1 atom in the reactant side of iron and there is a 3 in the product side. Hydrogen is a 2 in reactant product, and means it is a there's equal number of hydrogen, and oxygen has a 1 and 4. If we have a more than 2, if we have a 2 or more than 2 element in the equation, if the number of any one element is unequal in the reaction and product and reactant side, then equation is said to be unbalanced. Here the atom of the number of iron and oxygen in reactant and product are unequal, hence the equation is said to be an unbalanced equation. Now further, in the step 3, if the equation is unbalanced, what we need to do? We need to do the balance equation. So from where we should start to balancing the equation? The balancing of equation should be start from from that compound which has a maximum number of elements of, which has a maximum number of atoms of element. There are the four compounds. One is iron, H2O, Fe3O4 and H2. Add the how many atom present in that one, in this element, that is 1. In that compound there is a 2. In that 3 plus 4 there is a 7, and here there are the 2. So maximum number of elements are found in the compound of Fe3O4. So we should select first of all Fe3O4 in order to balance the chemical equation. But in Fe3O4 there are the two different elements. So in these two different elements, which one should we prefer first to solve it? So the next step is in the step 3rd, that we will select that one element which contain the maximum number of atom. So there are the iron element and the oxygen atom, but the iron contain the 3 atom, oxygen element contain the 4. Hence we will prefer to balance chemical equation to start from the oxygen. So we will select the Fe3O4 because it has a maximum number of atom in the compound overall, and in Fe3O4 we will select the O4 because the oxygen contain the maximum number of atom in Fe3O4 compound. So first select the compound and then select the element in that compound which contain the maximum number of atom. So we have select that compound, and now we have to select any one of them. So we have select the oxygen because oxygen contain the 4 atom in that compound. So on the left hand side oxygen has a 1 atom and right hand side oxygen has a 4 atom. Here O represent the oxygen atom. Note here O represent the 0. Okay, so left hand side has 1 oxygen atom, right hand side has a 4 oxygen atom. So further we will draw a column, 3 column for balancing, and the first column we will write atom of oxygen, in the second in reactant, and in third in product. So except atom of oxygen in the first, our initial condition in the reaction side, how many atom of oxygen are present? 1. In which compound are in which molecule it is present? It is present in a compound H2O. So we have simply said that the 1 atom of oxygen in reactant side present in H2O4, and 4 atom of oxygen present in product in Fe3O4 compound. So we need to balance it. For balancing we need to multiply the numbers or digits in either in product or in reactant, so that then there should be equal number of the atoms of that atom in both side, in reactant and product. So what we will do, we will multiply the 4 number with the H2O. In this condition or in this case, the number of oxygen atom should be 4, and here we will not multiply anything because the atom are now the atom of oxygen on the both hand side is equal. So in this way, on third step, we have balance the one element of that equation, and after that all we will write the equation. In this equation what we will do, we will do one extra thing, that we will write 4 number in front of the H2O, because here we have multiplied the 1 into 4 in with the 1, and that simply we can say that we have multiplied the 4 with the H2O. So we will write at here 4 in front of the box of the H2O. So that equation after step 3rd, that equation will be known as by the partially balanced equation and having a balanced oxygen atom. And there are some other further steps, step third, step fourth, step fifth, in which we will step by step balance the different elements. So for now, goodbye. We will continue into our further class.